So, are you focused?
Yeah, yeah, I'm
there. 38. I'll tell you everything.
So, Jesus died. Okay.
Yeah.
Jesus died.
Yeah, that's he all took simple. That's all. Died. Yeah. Yeah.
The story hasn't finished that. Story started from there, okay? So, Jesus died. He took his last breath. He died. Okay? Can someone who took their last breath, can they live after? Will you identify them as alive or dead?
I want to debate this. Cannot.
Identify dead.
You identify them as a dead. Okay, now, listen to this.
Even the Bible.
Isaac on the first day of the week, while it was dark, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb. This is the tomb of Jesus, okay? And saw that the stone had been removed from the entrance. So she came running to the Simon Peter and other disciples, the one Jesus loved, and said, they have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we don't know where they put him. So she went to the tomb where Jesus supposed to be buried. Okay, the stone in front of the tomb is moved, and there is no one inside that tomb. Okay, can that person walk around?
No, just was delusion, you know, imagination. They
answer my question. Can someone who is dead walk around?
No, of course.
No, okay. Of course. So, woman is saying, okay, tomb is empty, the body we put it, it's not there anymore.
Someone took his body.
Okay, we'll see. So, you believe someone came and then took the body of Jesus?
Yeah.
Why would someone do that?
Yeah, because maybe his body was in danger, someone wanna take.
He's already been dead. Why his body will be in danger?
Yeah, but there is some criminal, they wanna take the body.
Why? To do what?
Yeah, some criminal, you know, they wanna take.
So there are criminals around, I am very much aware, okay? There are community called protected group. Listen, there are the people identified as under the protected group, they are criminal. Okay, so I am asking you, why would a criminal took the body of Jesus?
But there is, that's not evidence, you know.
Answer my question.
Yeah.
Why would a criminal take the dead body?
No, you don't know really about this.
So you were just guessing, but you, because you said maybe
that's
someone.
That's not evidence.
You said maybe because someone took it.
Yeah,
and
maybe,
Now you are taking that claim back.
Yeah.
Okay? So thank you for taking that claim back. Now let me follow with you. So Peter and other disciples started for the tomb. Both were running, but the other disciples outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent over and looked at the stripes of the linen lying there, did not go in. So when someone dies, you know the kafan?
Yeah.
Yeah, so they covered his body. Yeah. And now, one of friends of Jesus, okay, looked into the tomb. He can see the fabric, but body is not there. Okay? So, but physical body, flesh is not there, but the fabric is there. Listen. Then Simon Peter, who was behind him, arrived and went into the tomb. He saw the strips of linen lying there, as well as the burial cloth that had been around Jesus' head. The cloth was folded up by itself, separated from the linen. Finally, the other disciples who had reached the tomb also went inside. He saw and believed. So both of them now seeing body is not there. Okay, this is the dead person. Now, then the disciples went back to their homes, but Mary stood outside of the tomb crying. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb and saw two angels in white, sitting while Jesus' body had been, one at the head and other one at the foot. They asked her, "Woman, why are you crying?" So, woman is upset, but is not there. Now, they are going to explain to him. "They have taken my Lord away," she said. And I don't know where they have put him. At this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there. That person is now standing there. And she did not realize it was Jesus. Woman, he said, why are you crying? Who is it you are looking for? Thinking he was the gardener, she said, sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have put him, and I will go, I will get him. Jesus said to her, Mary. She turned towards him and cried in Aramaic, Rabbani, which means teacher. Jesus said, do not hold on to me, for I have not returned to my father. Return to the father. Go and say to my brothers and then tell them, I am returning to my father and your father, to my God and your God. Mary Magdalene went to the disciples with the news, I have seen the Lord. And she told them he had told all these things to her. So that person was put into the grave, covered with the fabric, kefen, okay? People are going and seeing tomb is empty, stone is being moved, the dead body is not there, and the fabric which they covered Jesus is folded and put on the side, okay? And then Jesus is talking to this woman and then saying, hi Mary.
Yeah. I know, that's, there is full of history, that is his story. You know, I cannot trust this.
Why not?
Because everybody can.
So fight, you can't trust this one.
No, listen. I cannot trust all.
Listen. You
because
can't trust.
Is, you know,
listen. Listen.
Yeah.
Listen.
Yeah.
So you can't trust this one.
No.
Okay.
No.
So in here, Mary. Listen. In here, Mary, a woman, expressing her conversation with someone who just risen from death. Okay. And then also, chapter 21. Jesus is having food after his death and his resurrection. Jesus is having food with people, okay? He's risen and he's eating with Peter and some of other disciples, okay? And let me give you another example.
How are you?
Jesus was buried, and he was raised on the third day, according to scripture, that he appeared to Peter, one person, okay, then the 12, that's the 12 disciples. After that, he appeared more than 500 of brothers. At the same time, most of whom are still living. So when this guy is writing this book, he says 500 people saw Jesus is raised from the dead and walking among us, okay? He's alive. And then he says, then he appeared to James. James is the brother of Jesus, okay? Who didn't believe in Jesus, but after the resurrection, after Jesus conquered the grave, declared eternal life on us, after giving us life, now James is saying, oh, I believe Jesus is Lord who raised from the dead. Okay? So I gave you a name after name where it has been stated that people saw the guy who was dead, they saw with their own eyes, this guy was dead. Now this guy is alive.
No, do you know about his story of Pharaoh?
Pharaoh,
Egypt.
Which one?
Yeah.
There are lots of pharaohs.
No,
which one?
You know, who fight with... Yeah.
Pharaoh is the title for the king. Which king are you talking about?
The king who fought against Moses.
Okay.
Who fought against...
Okay,
you know,
which one?
They found their body... I don't know the exact Pharaoh. You know, who fought against Jesus, you know, he captured... And then they found their body, he wasn't drowned in the sea. You know, all scripture says, you know, he was drowned in the sea.
What is your name?
Gafur.
Gafur.
Yeah.
So, I need you to focus now.
No. Just
I need you to focus
now. This story is not true.
No,
we cannot trust. Nobody should trust.
Okay, so...
Because that's just imagination, you know, just people, they imagine he's raising from there. All the Christian waiting all 2,000 years for Jesus, he's coming, tomorrow is coming, next year is coming, he's not coming, he already is dead.
Let me respond to the claims you are making, which is very much, I must express, I'm very much disturbed what you are saying, first of all. Yeah. First of all.
Don't wait for Jesus.
First of all, you know the day is coming, King of Kings, Word of God, Lord Jesus Christ, who was crucified, buried and raised on the third day, will come to judge the world and take his bride with him. That's going to happen. Focus. He is going to come and do so. Okay? So first of all, that's first point. Second point is, you cannot simply tell me this Bible is not historically reliable without any backup. Okay? So first of all, let's do step by step. Are you ready for the King of Kings, Lord of Lords, the one who holds the universe with the power of his word? Are you ready for his return?
Yeah, I am.
You are ready?
No, but he's not coming. Of course.
Excuse me. You cannot say I am ready and he's not coming. He's coming. He is coming, and when he returns, so far, I do hope that I am misrepresenting you here right now. So far, you are not right place with him. When he comes, it's not going to be good for you at all. That's the first point. Listen, that's the first point. Second point is, since you are not ready for King of Kings, Lord of Lords return, let me ask you a very basic question. Since you talked about history, can you give me the name of the king at the time of Moses, which Moses was running away from?
I don't know about this.
You don't know? But you know that they find his body?
Pharaoh.
Yeah, which Pharaoh?
I don't know, there is a lot of Pharaoh. But
yeah, so which one? No. I'm asking you a very simple question.
I have to study about this.
It's not funny. I am asking you a very simple question, okay? So, there were lots of pharaohs. Give me the name of the pharaoh which fighted, or which Moses was running, taking people out of slavery. Which pharaoh?
No, I don't know. I have to study.
So, you don't know? Why did you make a claim that they find his body if you don't even know who he is?
Yeah, they found, you know.
I don't even know who he was.
I don't know the name. Just follow who fought against Moses.
Open up your Sheikh Google.
No, it takes time. I'm sorry.
Open up your internet and say, no, you are making a claim. Your claims has no ground to stand on, and you are telling me it takes time to find it. Open your internet and then tell me which pharaoh is that.
No, next time, because it's
when is next time?
I have to study. I have to find out.
Okay, you need to put your lines together and then come back. So far I am telling you, information you gave it to me is a false information, okay? Don't do that until you bring your evidence. That's the first point. Second point.
Yeah.
Read it with me.
Just I want to tell you one thing, you know, it's very simple. Don't waste your time for this religion.
I am not wasting my time for any religion at all. My life is already given.
That's very simple.
I already told you, you've got to repent. I will give you the reference for that, okay? I already exposed your one lie. This will be the second lie I will expose. And then I don't want you to lie again. So, first of all the life, all the breath I am given is a gift, okay? I'm not wasting anything. You are a lost soul whom my God made you in his image. He loves you, he cares for you, and he wants you to be his. That's the first point. Second point is very important. Listen to this very carefully.
Yeah.
Well, I'm telling you, from what you've just done, the lifestyle is not good. It's all up here, but not here. Well, you can't sin and expect God to bless you. Sorry, you can't. What are you here today?
Let the sea resound and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. Let the rivers clap their hands. Let the mountains sing together for the joy. Let them sing before the Lord. For he comes to judge the earth. He will judge the world in righteousness and the people with equality. He is going to come. He is going to come. And when he comes, right now I have sensed that you are not ready for his return. Okay?
When he comes, I will accept him.
No. It's not like, oh, when he comes, I will accept him. When he turns up, you know what you are going to do? You are not believers. You have not accepted Lord Jesus Christ as the Son of God who gave his life for you. So you will be freaking out in his return. As a Christian, I will be singing praises because he's coming to judge the world in righteousness and take me home. That's the first point. Second point is for you to help you to remember. When Lord Jesus comes, because he's so beautiful and he's so delightful, you will be on your knees, bowing down to him, and asking him to rescue you and redeem you, but that time it will be too late. So this is the account of John. When John sees Jesus, okay? When I saw him, I fell at his feet as though I was dead. So you can't simply say, when he comes, I am ready. When he comes, you will be on your knees. You will be on your knees and just standing on your feet. Then, see how beautiful my God is? Then he placed his right hand on me and said, do not be afraid. When Jesus returns, he's so beautiful, he's so delightful, he's so glorious. You will be on your feet and you will be afraid, you will be freaked out. Yet, Jesus will put his hand on your arm and then say to you, do not be afraid. I am the first and last. I am the first and last. I was dead and I am living one now.
I hope so. You know, I cannot trust the video. I cannot.
It is up to you. You trust it or not. Okay? But give me the reason. Where do you go for food shopping? Tell me, where do you go for food shopping?
Edgeworth.
You go to Edgeworth?
Yeah.
Have you ever bought a food which was already made?
Yeah.
So, why do you trust them when what you are buying?
Yeah, I can see.
You can see?
Yeah.
You didn't see how they were making that food?
No, but I can trust, you know, because
how?
He said if
why?
It's not good, I can return the food.
No, if you had it already and then if there was a poison, you can't return it.
Yeah,
how do you know the food you pay to eat it, there is no poison in it, it is edible. How do you know that?
I don't know.
You don't know. But in somehow, you trust that they are giving you something healthy. When you go to Marks and Spencer and buy a packet, a bottle of orange juice, so you hope that that's orange juice. You hope that is orange juice and that is healthy. And then you drink it. It might be something else. They pretended it was orange juice. So there is something, faith in you, that makes you to trust what they are selling you. There is something in this scripture. I can go to the British Museum, I can confirm with the history, and then something in this scripture tells me the man of this scripture, the one who gave himself on the cross for us, the one who loved us enough to give his life for us, is trustworthy. There is something in this scripture is being backed up by history and being backed up by the actions of Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, I can trust.
No, I don't want to waste your time. You know, there is a lot of contradiction in the Bible. But for me, it takes time to bring all this mistake, all this thing, you know.
I find that's very disturbing.
That's a problem,
Mr. Muslim.
I find
that's very disturbing. In a sense, you didn't even know that Lord Jesus Christ is today alive. You didn't even know that. You didn't even know Lord Jesus Christ is coming to judge the world in righteousness.
No, he's not coming.
I read it, and you still deny it. I can't do much about it.
So 99% is not coming back.
Not my truly, truly heavy return to judge the world in righteousness. Open your ears, listen it, and then take in heart and prepare yourself for his return. It's not gonna come. He's not coming with hot chocolate. He's coming to judge the world in righteousness. That's what he's coming for. Not offer you hot chocolate, okay?
No, no,
so that's the first point.
2000 years,
listen.
2000 years, Jesus is coming.
Listen.
Coming.
He will come when it is ready.
I'm sure he's not coming.
Oh well. When it turns up, when it turns up, you will know. You will know that.
Thank you.
So, I want you to read this with me. What do you do for a living?
Yeah, just work and living, that's all.
What do you do?
I work in the shop.
You work in the shop? What kind of shop? What do you sell?
Oh, off-license. Off-license.
What is that?
Off-license is grocery.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So you don't sell people eternal life, do you?
No.
No. Have you got anything in the shop which someone can buy that it will give them eternal life?
No, no.
No.
Of course.
That you find that sound is very strange. Do you think doctors today can give eternal life?
No.
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 Do you think imams can give eternal life?
No.
No. Do you think the Queen of England can give eternal life?
No, of course not.
Why not? They're all good. Like, doctors are good people. Queen of England
they
is good people.
Like us, you know, they are.
Okay, they are human. Humans cannot give eternal life.
No.
Who can give eternal life?
We don't know about God. We don't know about
who can give eternal life.
We don't know.
So someone who is not human.
No, no, we don't know about this
listen
guy.
My question. Someone who is not human can give eternal life, correct?
Maybe.
Maybe.
Yeah, maybe.
Can a dog can a dog give eternal life?
No.
No. So humans can't give eternal life, animals can't give eternal life.
No.
What are your other options? Who can give eternal life?
Yeah, we don't know about this God. Maybe, maybe.
Okay, maybe God gives eternal
maybe,
life.
Yeah.
Maybe,
yeah. 50-50%.
50-50.
Yeah.
Okay, let's take that risk.
Yeah.
Let's take that risk. So, Jesus is speaking.
Yeah.
Okay? Jesus answered, I did tell you, but you do not believe. The miracles I do in my Father's name speak for me. But you do not believe because you are not my sheep. My sheep listen to my voice.
Yeah.
I know them. They follow me. I give them eternal life. You said humans cannot give eternal life. In here, Jesus
can give
eternal life. So, so what does that make Jesus?
We have to be like sheep, you know?
I am a sheep. I am a sheep who went astray. So now answer my question.
Yeah.
If humans cannot give eternal life, if the dogs cannot give eternal life, and in here, man, okay, who's got hands, who's got body parts, speaks, says, I give eternal life, what does that make that? And what does that make him?
I am sorry, I cannot trust you. I'm sorry.
I don't want you to put your sorry face on. Okay,
no, no,
focus.
This is, I cannot.
It's, I don't care you trust it or not. I am asking you.
Yeah.
If sake of the argument, if this is what it says, what does it say about Jesus? If it is correct, what does it say?
No, no, that's just book. You know, that's book. I'm sorry.
That's not my question.
That.
That's not my question.
Yeah.
As I read it to you, what does it say to you about Jesus? I haven't come to the part, why don't you trust, okay? So far, as I read it to you, what does it tell you about Jesus?
Jesus can give eternal life.
Okay, so you said humans cannot give eternal life.
Yeah.
Okay,
Jesus
you
can.
Said 50-50 God might give eternal life.
Yeah.
So in here, Jesus is 50-50 God?
No, really, I don't know.
No, no, I am not asking what you know, what you don't know. I am asking what did you understand as I
Jesus
read it.
Jesus can give eternal life. Yeah, I understand.
Okay,
this,
Jesus can give eternal life.
Yeah.
What that makes Jesus?
God.
Okay, that makes Jesus God. So now we identify.
According to this book,
yes,
according to my opinion.
That's okay. Your opinion is going to change if it is raining. Your feelings are going to move around. But thank you for confirming. According to this book,
yeah,
that makes Jesus God. Only God gives eternal life. And
yeah,
listen
yeah.
this very carefully.
Yeah.
It's not an eternal life. Okay? This is perfect, glorious life. Listen this very carefully. My sheep listen to my voice. I know them and they follow me. I give them eternal life and they shall never perish. No one can snatch them out of my hand. They will never perish. No one can snatch them out of my hand. My Father who has given them to me is greater than all. No one can snatch them out of my Father's hand. I and Father, we are one. It is not an eternal life that you will suffer in certain time and place, but it is eternal life. It is perfect. There is no any punishment. There is nothing like causes you to kind of stumble or anything. It is perfect life because that eternal life comes with God Himself. So now we identified Scripture is telling us Jesus is God. What are you going to do about it?
No, really, I cannot trust this Bible.
Why?
I'm sorry.
Why?
I'm sorry, guys.
You're...
I cannot trust. Yeah.
What? Okay.
Yeah.
No. It's not like God bless you. He says, I am sorry, and he smiles.
No,
where did this come from? It is very serious. It is very serious. You just told me, according to the Bible, Jesus is God, and then you say, oh,
no,
I am sorry. Smiling. Listen. Smiling doesn't make you to think, doesn't make me to think that you are sorry. Smiling makes me to think actually you are very happy that you are
happy,
rejecting
you know?
God Himself. On the day of judgment, that's not going to be very good. So now, make your case.
I am happy.
Make your case. Why don't you trust into this book?
Next time I will come in, maybe.
I am assuming there might be not next time. Life is too short. Every breath we take in and we give it out is a gift from God. Next time might be too late.
No, 99% I am coming next time.
You are not God. You don't know. You don't know.
Yeah, at least
you don't
95%,
know. You don't know. I don't know. But all I can tell you is
you don't know. You said you're God. You don't know about God.
I am not God.
Yeah.
Excuse me. I am not God. I never said I am God.
No, no.
I don't
know.
I don't know if you are gonna make it back an hour after this conversation. I don't know if I am gonna make it back an hour after this conversation. I don't know if I'm gonna make it back here next week. But all I know is, Mr. all I know is, Father, who is delighted in His Son, in the fellowship of Holy Spirit, loved you enough to send His one and only Son to give Himself for you. That one and only Son, Lord Jesus Christ, buried, grave was empty, tomb was empty,
yeah,
raised on the third day, and He's going to come to judge the world.
I hope so.
Yeah, so as you hope so, when that happens, I hope that you will be on your knees. You will be on, that will be too late. You will be on your knees and awed and amazed by His beauty.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Essential for you to remember, when you come back next time with your objections on the reliability
yeah.
of the Christian scripture, you've got to pull yourself together and then keep in your mind again and again that Father loved you so much.
Thank
he
you.
Gave His one and only Son. That one and only Son loved you so much. He gave Himself for you. He wants you to repent and then run to the arms which has been opened for you on the cross. That's all He wants.
Yeah, yeah. Well, thank you very much.
Okay, see you next week.
Big hot chocolate.
Yeah.
Have you read the Bible? Have you read the Bible?